Good evening, panel and my fellow presenters. This is Mohit Bhutta from National Forensic Science University, MSc Forensic Psychology. And today I'll be talking about the comparison of the outcome of LPA from the police personal interrogation files and the forensic psychologist. One of the most common tool of deceptive behavior is lying. The people lie often to save themselves from unfavorable future outcomes. Police and interrogating are mostly looking for a way to either point out lying behavior or use techniques which reduce the chances of suspects to lie about any given situation. Interrogation or forensic interview tend to be socially stressful situation for an individual. Hence, acute stress activation can be seen due to psychophysiological changes in the body. Social stresses stimulate the HPA, which is the hypothalamus pituitary, and the adrenal axis, which is seen as unpredictable and is responsible for production of neurohormone cortisol from the adrenocortical gland. The outcome is seen in an individual's voice and speech patterns, which may be analyzed with lie detectors and during a forensic interview through the evaluation of verbal and nonverbal cues. LVA, layered wise analysis, Israel-based screening tool. It's a culturally software-based instrument which works on voice analysis. It is the case that in this field setting, LVA is used indeed directly interact with those who undergo this testing. The law establishes that everyone has right to freedom of expression and speech. Each individual is allowed to consent to the testing on this basis. Then only we as forensic psychologists can administer such tests. On the other hand, forensics interview isn't just a standalone procedure, but can be used while administrating psychological and screening tools like polygraph, LBA, BSA, SDS, BOSM, etc. Mostly the interviews and interrogation are done by the investigation officer, police officer, which has bare minimum training in the how to conduct an interview for the screening tools, as these tools are majorly rely on the narrator given by the suspect. Next slide, please. Liars have a higher pitched voice and longer pauses than truth tellers when it comes to voice characteristics. Only a few non-verbal behavior appear to be consistently related with deception, suggesting that liars are more tensed and make fewer leg, foot, hand or arm motions. There is much agreement in the investigative interview literature that the best practices for obtaining precise and comprehensive information from witnesses interviews format should contain a time of rapport building, an explanation of the interview's goals and ground rules, introduction of the topic, eliciting a free narrative account, clarifying the point, facts, and the conclusion. Additionally, on the base of the material reviewed, there are the proper disuse design intervention for conducting a forensic risk assessment and interviews. That is planning, introduction, rapport formation, and questioning methods. Furthermore, Inbau and his colleagues refer to other right technique are designed to tear down the suspect resistance and improve the likelihood of obtaining a confession from them. In order to do this, they have a 9-step method which is used to deal with the suspect denial and negative mood while consistently emphasizing the benefits of delivering a proper confession. The police regards human rights as a hindrance to interrogation, in part of because the widespread cultural acceptability and guilt perception environment associated with the interrogation, as well as the resulting conventional hierarchical social structure that the Bureau of Democracy and Human Rights and Labor in 2003 identifies as one of the several factors contributing to the perpetuation of such violations. As far as we are aware, there have been no prior study in India that evaluates attitude towards or acceptance of coercive tactics as an effective way of investigating questioning. There are several benefits to expanding an awareness of such views, including the potential influence on the decreasing malpractice, enhancing training, reduce the possibility of false confession, and widening an understanding of how professionals in India interpret human rights regulations. Stress is rather an amorphous term that is used in wide variety of fields, ranging from engineering to physics to biology. In biology, it refers to an unpleasant event that might have negative physiological, emotional, cognitive, behavioral effects. From the previous slide only, we are still there, sorry. Yes, sir. Able to maintain, yes, sorry. Furthermore, what defines a stressor is even capable of eliciting a stress varies from between organism to individual. The next slide, ma'am. The study aims to examine the difference between the interview taken by a forensic expert and a police officer through LVA detection summary. Next one, ma'am. Next one. The hypotheses are the truth and the stress levels are equal in police interrogated LVA report and the DFS cases. And the alternative is the truth and stress level are not equal in the police interrogated LVA report and DFS cases. The study will be limited to the examination of comparison of LBA detection summary from the secondary data obtained from the Directorate of Forensic Science, Gandhinagar. Next slide. 40 samples are taken, 20 each from police interrogated LBA outcomes and forensic psychological outcomes. The research journal will be non-experimental study. Will be taken the voice samples from the year of 2018 to 2020 from the forensic psychology division of DFS. Next. The corresponding values by the police personnel LBA report show stress values of mean 0.20 and SDF 0.4. Whereas the forensic psychology saw 0.09 and the SDF 0.04. In the truth, there was minimal differences. As you can see, the police interrogated file showed mean and SDF 0.05 and forensic psychology 0.04 and 0.02. Next slide, ma'am.
Thank you.
The voice samples derived through the interview conducted by the police personnel and forensic psychologists via the LV automated report showed that they are surmised in many ways. The stress values are high because of the nature of the uniform and the role of police personnel may elicit social stress when interrogated, whereas it is significantly low when interviewed by a forensic psychologist, as the standard procedure, standard operating protocol binds them to maintain rapport with the suspect and follow human rights norms. At the same time, the truth values revealed insignificant difference in the LBA reports of the police personnel and forensic psychologists, yet believing that low stress elicit better calibration for the baseline in the LBA procedure, and it also surfaced better narrative of events to screen out segment analysis for a better outcome. The result of the study shows that the stress values were undoubtedly indifferent than the truth values. However, the most revealing and unexpected observation are that both stress and truth values may differ because of the different protocol and procedures followed differently by the police personnel while interrogation and forensic interview procedure by the forensic psychologist. Also, the nature. Yes, ma'am.
Speaking too fast. I'm saying just go slow. You're speaking too fast for us to just really get it. So it's a request, go slow, because time constraint is for everyone, but you have to present it nice. Okay.
All right, ma'am. Do you want me to
finding part? This is your finding part, so just go slow.
All right. So yes, the stress and the truth levels are unexpectedly different because of the different protocol and the procedures followed by the differently by the police personnel while interrogation and the forensic entry procedure by the forensic psychologist. Also, the nature of the offense in the instance considered for the cases was corruption, which does not come into within the categories of serious or heinous crimes. This explains why the stress levels were low during a forensic psychologist LBA outcome, as this type of crime does not produce as much tension as other types of crime. Also, according to Bobby Webuck and Hare in 2006, they conducted a study where they found out that white-collar offenders exhibit personality traits such as narcissism, self-centeredness, egoism, disagreeableness, competitiveness, manipulativeness, anger, and hostility, which explain the observed differences in the stress and the truth levels of LBA reports. Along with the truth and the stress level, the LBA automated report analysis considers a variety of additional criteria. The forensic psychologist's role is to relieve stress in order to optimize segment analysis results. The detection summary reveals that following truth stress, high risk, medium risk, inaccuracy, SOS, high stress and low stress as assessed by segment analysis and reported by the forensic psychologist. Furthermore, according to Indian law, under Article 20, Subsection 3, the Protection Against Self-Incrimination, and Article 21, Right to Life and Personal Liberty, the suspect has the right to refuse permission for a test or a tool. Possessing a sense of power or control decreases the likelihood of encountering opposition or resistance during the interview or exam administration. Valuing and respecting the human rights of an individual is an utmost importance in the field of law enforcement. Next slide, ma'am. The study was conducted to compare the automated report of LBA on voice samples conducted by the police personnel and forensic psychologists. The result concluded the difference in the truth and the stress values of two groups obtained via detection summary analysis. It is understood that the LBA calibrates subsequent results from baseline obtained while interrogation or forensics interview. Hence, it includes that better rapport formation may reduce stress for better baseline and voice segment analysis via LBA. Thank you.